Hey guys! Today I wanted to show you how to create this adorable Father's Day gift. And this is going to be a gift basket, but it will also double as a toolbox. So if you want to know how to make one of these, then just keep watching. So the first thing I want to make is the box. And for that, I'm going to be recycling an old shoe box. And you can see this one is very battered, but it really doesn't matter because it's going to be covered. I'll also be using some scissors. I'll be using a marker pen and also a pencil, a ruler, a hot glue gun. I'll also be using some masking tape and some double-sided tape. And to cover the box, I'm going to be using some fancy wrapping paper. And these ones are super cute because they have mustaches on them. So that's what I'm going to be using. So the first thing you want to do is you want to find the center point on the side of your box. And I'm using my ruler and I'm just going to make a little mark on the halfway point. And I'll do that on top and bottom of the box and then I'll just draw a line. Then on the bottom of the box, I'm going to make a little tick mark about an inch away from that line on both sides. And then I'm gonna turn the box around and I'm going to make a little tick mark 3 inches away from that line on both sides. Once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and link those two tick marks and I'm going to do that on both sides. And this is just going to serve as a guide for me later. And make sure you do that on both sides of the box. Once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and draw a straight line on the back of the box as well. I'm just linking the center points together here. And this is going to also serve as a guide, and you'll see that a little bit later. So now I'm just going to go ahead and cut out that center section. So I'm just cutting on the diagonal lines and then just cutting off that piece, and I'll do that for both sides. And now you can see how that line on the back is going to serve me as a guide. I'm just going to draw that line in the center of the box. And then I'm going to take the back of the pin and I'm just going to crease on that line. And that's just going to help me fold this box in half a little bit easier. And as you can see, the box is starting to form. And we're going to need some panels for the side. And for that, I'm going to be using the top of the box or the lid of the box. I'm going to measure the right size and I'm going to cut out those pieces from the lid. And you can see here, I've already cut that out. And then I'm adhering this with the masking tape. And I ended up going a little bit masking tape crazy here, so I added quite a lot because I don't want the box to fall apart. And I ended up reinforcing the inside as well. Once you've done that, cut out another piece which is going to be your handle. So cut a piece of the right size to fit on the top of the box and then fold that in half. I ended up sketching the handle here with this kind of wavy line, and once I cut it out, I actually changed my mind and then I just cut that into a straight line. And I took the piece that I cut out from the handle to cut out that inner section as well. And now before I adhere the handle to the box, I need to glue the box together. So I'm just adding some hot glue all over the back of the box, and then I'm going to press that together. And I'm not worrying too much about the corners because I can go ahead and add some glue all the way around so that the box is really well stuck together. And once that's done, I can go ahead and adhere my handle in place. And I used hot glue gun for that as well. But I decided to add some masking tape to reinforce that and make sure that that doesn't break apart. And the box is pretty much complete now, and all I need to do is cover that up with the paper. And I'm not going to bore you guys and let you watch me wrap this box, but what I did was I covered this box in sections. So you can see here I've cut out smaller pieces and covered section by section. And once I finish doing that, the box is completely covered and ready to use. So I think that looks really fun. Okay, so this is the part where you can personalize this gift to fit the person you're giving this to. You can really add anything you want. I just decided to add some snacks and some drinks, and I've even added a small little gift. You can put some newspapers in there or a magazine or anything really. I just think this is a really fun gift for all of your dad's favorites. So then next thing you need to do is remember to add a tag to this, and then your basket is complete. Now you can give it to your dad, and I'm sure he's going to love enjoying all of those goodies. So once your dad has enjoyed his drinks and his snacks, he can then go ahead and use his basket as a toolbox. So this box can fit a lot of tools in there, and it's also very handy because remember we created that handle so it can be taken anywhere he wants. And just remember to have fun creating this for that special someone in your life. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you can receive updates when I post new videos. And also, if you could take a minute to click the like button, that would really help this channel and show some support. Thanks for watching. Bye!